Hello, beautiful and smart people. Now that I got your trust, let's talk about primes. If I don't find primes every day, life is not good. Okay, let's look at this again. Okay. Here's a small digest cycle, very, very simple in Angular 1. It's going away, but right now it exists. I have a scope, I have number of primes, and I'm finding them if number of n changes. So I try to read, I need more primes in Christopher Walken's voice. So I click, and I wait, and I click again, and I try, and I'm trying to actually scroll right now, but it's frozen, right? Okay, now it's appeared. I call this coffee scripting. My script is executing, and I'm going to get some coffee. So Angular, you know, is very large, right? And if I want to show what my main idea, I need to really focus on just the scopes and digest cycle. So the guy, Terror P, I know he's actually watching this from Europe. He wrote a blog, and now ebook, and go check it out, where he builds up Angular step by step. So this is the first part of his blog where he shows how to create a scope, how to have a watch function and a listener function, and see every scope instance has these $$ watchers. So I'm using $2 signs. That means I know what I'm doing. Just like these sleeves mean that I'm serious and I'm working hard. So that's just taking too long. Here's the idea. Why don't we move digest cycle and the model into separate thread from the browser? So the browser will still be responsive while the primes are computed. So that's what I've done. So I moved my micro Angular and the primes.js into a web worker, and on the client side, I left the same API, mock scopes. So I'm clicking, I can scroll, I can click again, it's computing a lot more, but see, it's like the page is responsive. Boom. Okay. The client just had to change a little bit. Instead of saying scope n equals something, I have to use set method. And in reality, every scope creation or setting a property or kicking off digest cycle is just a post message to the web worker where the actual Angular is. So my mock scopes that the client sees actually just deliver messages using post message mechanism. I'm actually stringifying all the functions like watch and listener function, and I'm sending it as text, and I'm recreating, so you lose lexical scope, but you can access everything on the scope. And when the worker that receives messages actually calls the Angular methods. And the interesting thing is, because it has the model, it has to create HTML, and when the digest cycle runs, the green arrow, it has to send back HTML. And you're wondering, well, can I compute the diff of a virtual DOM and send it? Yes. But Fermat, I'll just leave a proof to the reader. Okay. Next. So Angular team likes to change everything, right? And I don't. And I hate using setter methods. This is not Java. This is JavaScript. So I don't want to change. Yeah, hating Java always brings applause. Okay, so I use Object Observe, and I put an observer on the scope instance on the client side. So every time there is a property change, I actually get an event. I can send it to my web worker. And just to prove that it works, I'll print the change event. And on the next slide, see, it actually detected that I use, scope.n equals whatever. And so I have a fever, and the only medicine is more primes. Okay, right there. Right there. Okay, that's the end of my talk. I have 35 seconds. I'll be there. If you have any questions, I charge very cheaply to answer a question, just one beer per question. You have a code, you have a blog post. Please check out Camshore. We're a financial insight company in Boston and New York City. We open source several Angular libraries. We love Angular, as you can see at the bottom of our slides. Thanks.